much you love him. It's okay how you're doing, but just let them know that you love them. And Lord, we give you our honor. We welcome you into this place, Jesus. Oh, how we love you, Jesus. Oh, how we praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Oh, don't stop there. Don't stop there. Give us a heart to give to you, Jesus.
Oh,
don't you stop by CMC to tell you.
Just want to tell you, Lord, I love you.
There's nobody like you, Lord, in all of your majesty, in all of your splendor, in all of your righteousness. You are a just God. You are a worthy God, and
I love Jesus.
I worship
and adore.
Just want to tell you, Jesus. I don't want to complain, Jesus, but I just want to say I love
you.
Let us go into the house of the Lord. Oh, bless him. Bless him. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I just come to say that, listen, if you have seats beside you, we need you to kind of like tighten up, move to the end or move to the center real quick, because I see a lot of empty seats in between. Amen. We're going to need you to put your purse on the floor. That don't mean you're going to have no bad luck or no, you're going to get no money or nothing like that. Let's quit all that foolishness. You know what I'm saying? Amen. You're already blessed and highly favored of the Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord make it rich and add no sorrow. Hallelujah. But I see some empty right in between. So if you could just kind of like scoot over so there won't be, it'd be like three empty right there together, so somebody can sit together with the folks. All right. Amen. Hallelujah. If you just move on over, then somebody can find their folks and sit with them. Hallelujah. Amen. Isn't the Lord good? Isn't the Lord good? Amen. Let's give the Lord another praise offering. Amen. We got plenty of them. So we ain't got to pull out no chairs. There's plenty in between. So ushers, you kind of like, you know, y'all got my permission to tell them, can y'all scoot over a little bit? They ain't going to fuss at you. Amen. They're here to see you cheering. So they ain't going to fuss at you. I just want everybody to be seated comfortably. All right? Amen. 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 Y'all come to enjoy the Lord today. Amen. Come on, clap those hands one more time. Amen. But I'm going to bring on the person that's going to do our emceeing today, the person who I'm familiar with, who I love dearly, been with for almost 34 years of marriage, been known her all my life, basically, since a child. I want you to stand to your feet and welcome the First Lady, amen, the administrator of CFA, our very own Dr. Veronica G.B.
About. I am so excited I couldn't hardly rest. I see myself here last night at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning. So finally we are here. And I'm glad that everybody is here and we are excited about our church family, Christian Fellowship Church, as well as our CFA family that's here with us today. And thank you all for coming to be a part of this great, great, great service on today. And this is our Big Heart Sunday. We'd like to say Happy Valentine's Day to each and every one of you. And of course, this has been deemed as the Love Month. Amen. So I hope the person that you sit beside, that you truly do love them. And amen. If you don't know them, just tell them, hey, God loves you. Yes, they are loved by God. So we're going to do something a little different today, so that we can get everybody in place. Of course, if your child is in K2, K3, and K4, they should already be in the fellowship hall. If they are K2, K3, and K4, please, please take them on to the fellowship hall. And they should already be in place, getting ready to do what they need to do. And then if your children are in Ms. Hargrove's class, we need you to stand up and make your exit where we did what we practiced on these past weeks. So from Ms. Hargrove's class, Ms. Griffin's class, Ms. Marsh class, we want you to go ahead on and take your rightful places. That way we won't get mixed up in the crowd as I introduce the crowd to each other and everything. So we want our older children to get in place so that they will not run over our smaller children. And so that's how we have practiced it, that we do things decently and in order, but we respect the little ones and we don't want to just run over them. But here at CFA, a lot of our church family, you have heard us mention about CFA, but you really don't know where we all have come from. This vision was birthed inside of my heart when I homeschooled my children for 3 years, and after 3 years, it was pressed upon my heart to start a homeschool. So this Christian Fellowship Academy started out as a homeschool. And it has ventured up to where we are now, 125 strong and growing. Amen. So we are grateful to the Lord for that. Y'all can do better than that. God has really blessed us. Yes, he has. truly, truly blessed us, and we are thankful to the Lord for all that he has done. And we do want to thank God for how he has provided for us and how he has brought these wonderful parents, grandparents our way, and then even with our church family has supported us along the way. And Bishop B has allowed us to do what we do without all of the overhead, and the church has been just such a great supporter. They have really been the rock of CFA. So let's give our bishop, amen, a hand for allowing us to do what we do here on a day-to-day basis. We thank you so much, Bishop, for allowing us to practice the vision. Yes, indeed. So, of course, now if you were in second grade, first grade, K-5, you can make your exit to the fellowship hall as well. And everyone will be getting in their places. And we ask that you be patient with us as we bring forth our little ones and everybody get into their rightful places. And then I know our teachers are out, but we cannot do what we do alone. When you have a vision, you have to have people to tie into the vision. They have to buy into the vision. So with that, I have a great teaching staff as well as administrative staff that help us do what we do on a day-to-day basis. And I am very appreciative to the Lord for bringing me such wonderful people that have passion like I have passion about these children. Because children, they are our future, but they also, we need to invest into the future in order for them to become the future. So that's what we are doing. And I thank God for the parents who send their children here on a week-to-week basis to help us to, we are able to help them raise their children. And, you know, we want them to become productive citizens for the kingdom of God as well as for the USA. And then while we are there, we have Black History Month, which is this month. I hope one day that your child will make a difference so that someone will be reading about them one day, how they paved the way for others. And so that's what it's all about. So with that in mind, we're going to ask Bishop B and our armor bearers, we're going to come down, and we're going to just enjoy what we do here on a day-to-day basis, because we enjoy it every day. Our children give us a big laugh every day. So I think you're going to be very, very proud of your children and what CFA and CFC does on a day-to-day basis. All right? Yes. K-5, are you out as well? K-5. Ms. Boyd's class. All right, we have just about everybody in place. All right, CFA, are you ready? Let's go.
Nobody can.
us because previous engagements, but we were excited about the ones that are here. Now, if you're going to record, please, we ask that you record in the back because you're standing up and others cannot see. And, of course, we're going to be bringing the babies on stage so you can see well. But if you're going to record something, please stand in the back because it's not fair to those who are sitting, okay? Did I say that in much love? Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right.
Raven Hunt. Tori Jones. Bailey Brooks, Kayla Jones, Lauren Head. Sari, would you come down for Kayla? And Nadia Galloway, would you come down for Braden? Sari, you gonna do the flag, the American flag? Stand, please.
I pledge allegiance
Jason Gaines, Bruce Foster, Jasmine Stanley, Josiah Phelps Lewis, Caleb Barnes, Angela Hughes, Nicholas Dyson, and Matthias Watson. You may be seated. Jackson.
Hello, parents. My name is Jackson. So, and I'm a 7th grade class. And I grew up, I'm going to be a teacher like my mom and my daddy.
My name is Jeremy Spencer, and I was going to K-4 class. Well, I grew up, I'm going to be a teacher just like my mom.
And I am Miss Charles K-4 class. And when I grow up, I want to be a doctor.
Hello, family and friends. My name is Bruce Foster Jr. And I'm in Ms. Boyd's K-5 class. When I grow up, I want to be a firefighter.
My name is Jasmine Stanley. I am Miss Ridge's first grade class, and when I grow up, I want to be a family doctor.
Hello, family friends. My name is Josiah Phelps Lewis. Miss Phillips, second grade class. When I grow up, I want to be an officer in the United States Air Force.
Hello, family and friends. My name is Angela Hughes. I am in my third grade class. When I grow up, I want to be a police officer.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Dyson, and I'm in Ms. Griffin's fourth grade class. When I grow up, I want to be a professional baseball player.
Hello, my name is Matthias Watson, and Ms. Hargrove's fifth grade class. And when I grow up, I want to be a surgeon.
Let's give them a hand. These are our future. And now we're going to have a song from K2, K3, Ms. Simmons, and Ms. Hansel's class. So let's give them a hand. They say come. Musicians, you all can play a little something till we get them. It takes us a little minute with our babies. Another hand, these are 2 and 3 year olds. Thank you.
on, everybody. Let's give God this worship. If you know he's awesome, come on, stand on your feet, everybody. If you know he's awesome, you're in all of his grace. You're in all of his goodness. You're in all of his mercy. You're in all of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say, he can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Come on, say it, hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
That's it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened.
Forever he'll reign.
Come on, you got it. My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Come on, say,
he can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain. Has he ever covered you? Come on, my God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength where I've been weakened. Forever he'll reign. Yeah, my God is awesome.
God is
listen,
awesome.
Today I am forgiven.
I am forgiven.
His grace is why I'm living. Somebody ought to praise his holy name. Come on, you say, my God.
My God is awesome.
Come on, awesome.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice and testify.
Oh, things are going wrong.
Praise,
praise him.
Praise,
help me in here.
Praise,
come on and praise.
Praise.
Oh,
known as Ricky Styles. Holla if you hear me now. Ladies, set it off, floss the prop. Fellas lost the 20s and flaunt the dollar. Worldwide as we glide from city to city, state to state, as we cultivate your faith. The gem and trinity, the diamond remedy, praise extremity. Now get your hop on.
Amen. Let's give them another hand. Didn't they do a great job? Wonderful, wonderful job. And this is what your children are inspired to be, is become more and more productive and become more confident in who they are. And some of our alumni sent the message to our congregation to let you know where they have come from, because we have, I'm sorry, I'm turning my back. We had middle school and high school before, and that's where we headed back to. So we're going to hear from a few, amen, that's where we headed back to. And the children that have graduated here, of course, we sent messages out to as many as we could, and these are the ones that responded. So we're going to let you hear from them, all right? Let's give them a hand.
My name is Teresa Williams, and I graduated as valedictorian of Christian Fellowship Academy's class of 2010. I began college at Middle Georgia State University in June of 2010, and in May of 2014, I graduated magna cum laude and as a President's List Scholar with my Bachelor's of Science degree in Information Technology with concentrations in Information Security and Networking Administration. Since then, I have become the assistant director at Kingdom Builders Faith-Based Learning Center, and I am also a certified Zumba instructor. I'm also involved in my local community, and I am very involved in my church.
Hi, my name is Sonoria Kane, class of 2006 from CFA. When I came to CFA, I was a junior. Prior to that, I had attended public school the whole entire time, so coming to CFA was a big transition for me. Since leaving CFA, I've become successful. I got my bachelor's in psychology, and I recently went on to get my master's in school counseling. I've also maintained some great relationships with the people that I've met at CFA. It really influenced some of the decisions that I made me work hard, and I've just learned a lot from CFA. So I really appreciate everything that they've done for me, and always go Eagles.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rachel Sproul. I am not going to be before you long. Most of you all know me from Christian Fellowship Church. I am a proud alumni of Christian Fellowship Academy 2009. Since then, I have graduated with degrees, working on my final and last. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Oh my gosh, time I think about that, I get happy. Anyways, since then, I've just been enjoying life, working as a college student and also as an adult independent person. I go to the best church on this side of heaven, Christian Fellowship Church, as I stated before. How CFA has impacted my life, I can truly say I'm still living CFA. I not only see majority of the same people of Christian Fellowship Church, but It has taught me to learn who I am as a believer in Christ and as a child of God. When I went, I was about 13. And ever since then, you go through these steps and phases of learning who you are. I might have not learned at that point in time who I was, but a seed was planted because of the teachers and the students and your peers in this Christian environment. And because of that seed was planted, I have grown to be a great woman of God. I know my worth. I know who I am. I know what Christ wants me to do. And for that, I can truly say that there has not been a school where I have said, oh, I wish I didn't go there, or I wish I didn't do this, and I wish I didn't do that. I truly can say I'm glad that I went to Christian Fellowship Academy. So for right now, like I said, I'm just enjoying life, living one day at a time, letting God take control, because that is the main important thing. You do put Him first, and He will do the rest. So until then, I have a little cousin. He's here. I was trying to do the video without him. Say hi, Jordan. But until then, I hope everyone be blessed and see y'all soon.
Hello, my name is Myra Wilkins, and I'm class of 2006. From Christian Fellowship Academy. I am one of the originals that I was here since day one when my mother started the school. So I had definitely seen this school grow, and it is still growing. So we thank God and praise God for that. Since then, I graduated from Georgia Military College with my associate's degree in middle grades education in 2008. And then in 2010, I graduated from California University of Pennsylvania online, and I got my sports management degree. Currently, I'm trying to get my master's degree at Georgia Bible College. Y'all pray for me. I'm trying to finish in biblical studies. Right now, I am married, and I've been married. Matter of fact, this year will be 7 years. So God is continually blessing me and my marriage. And right now, we have a little one. He's 10 months, little EJ Elliott Jr. So I praise God for that. And next year he'll be here. He'll be one this year. So next year he'll be starting CFA. And I just thank God, because it's the next generation that is starting CFA. So I thank God that CFA is still going and it's going strong. And I'm going to praise God when we move over to the other building. That's going to be awesome. So y'all continue to pray. Y'all continue to support CFA, because I know that God is in this. So I thank God for the current students. I pray that y'all bring them back, because CFA is going places. I thank God for the wonderful staff and the teachers there back then, and still now today, they are awesome. So I thank God for the founders, and continue to stay strong. Go Eagles, and thank you for creating champions. God bless.
My name is Adam Johnson, and I graduated from Christian Fellowship Academy class of 2009. Since graduation, I had an opportunity to go to Harvard University and perform research in the Department of Chemical and Biological Sciences. In 2011, with the help of the Christian Fellowship Church family, I was able to go with the Tropical Pathology and Infectious Disease Association to Kingsey Mill and Cusco, Peru for a mission trip. In 2013, I graduated from Morehouse College with my Bachelor's of Science in Biology, and currently I am a third-year medical school student at Boston University School of Medicine, and prayerfully, if everything goes well, I will be receiving my Doctorate of Medicine in May 2017. Myra asked us to basically say what the impact that Christian Fellowship Academy had on us. And for me, two of the biggest impacts, one was having the opportunity to be taught by both of my parents, the late Marilyn Johnson and Elder Wilbur Johnson. I think it just really showed their commitment to the education of myself, my sister, and all the students that were here at the academy. And two, it was really being able to go to school with my role model, my best friend, my sister, Dr. Victoria Johnson. Being able to see her excel academically here and graduating as the first valedictorian inspired me to do the same for my class, and I really have followed her path and leadership and excellence into becoming a physician. So if I had to say anything to the current students at Christian Fellowship Academy, I would say really take to heart the proclamation. You all are truly King's kids, and you all can do all things through Christ who strengthens you.
Hello everyone, I am Jasmine Howard, a proud 2008 graduate of Christian Fellowship Academy. After my time here, I went to Fort Valley State University where I received my bachelor's in psychology as well as graduated with honors. During my time at Fort Valley State University, I served as Miss Fort Valley State University for the 2010-2011 scholastic year. After my time at Fort Valley, I was able to come back and share that knowledge as a K-3 teacher here at Christian Fellowship Academy. No greater joy than to be able to come back and give back what was given to me. After my time here, I went back to Fort Valley State University as an admissions counselor, where I have a wonderful opportunity to give children in high school the opportunity to get a college education, so that brought great joy as well. After my time there, I was accepted into a very rigorous program at AT&T in their Business Sales and Leadership Development program. After completing the program and finishing second out of 11 students, I chose to take another position as a claims associate at GEICO for liability claims. So my experience at Christian Fellowship Academy has shaped me as the woman I am today. It provided much nurturing and it provided much education spiritually as well as naturally that has allowed me to impact lives to this day. So I'm very grateful for the vision that God shared with you, First Lady B and Bishop B, and I pray that people continue to catch hold to the vision and the great things that are still going here at Christian Fellowship Academy. I'm a proud Eagle, invest.
Hi, my name is Jarius B, the one and only. I'm just playing. I am class of 2004, the first graduating class, the best graduating class, may I say. And I went on to a college, American Intercontinental University, where I studied media and sound engineering. And now I serve as the chief operating officer of the winning church, the best church on this side of heaven, Christian Fellowship Church, where I thoroughly enjoy serving you guys. And also, no kids, not married, but that's on the way. Mine's on the way, mine's on the way. Just kidding, too churchy. But I thoroughly enjoyed coming to CFA. I was the first student. Me and my sister were homeschooled at the house off of Green Street out there somewhere on the other side of town. And now it's grown to 125 students, which is wonderful. And I applaud CFA, the teachers, the staff, the best principal on this side of heaven, my mom, Dr. Veronica B. We applaud you. And thank you for not quitting and giving up on us. Thanks and God bless.
Hello, my name is Jamie Alum, and I graduated from CFA in 2005. After graduating from CFA, I spent time teaching piano, received an associate's degree in biblical studies from Georgia Bible College, as well as received my bachelor's in music business from Full Sail University. After completing college, I spent time volunteering, consulting, and managing independent artists, as well as working for an international jewelry company. CFA has made a big impact in my life, being in an industry that's filled with so many temptations. I was able to stay focused and not conform to the world's way of thinking. That's one of the most important lessons I learned attending CFA, is I can work in the world and associate with them, but I don't have to live the way they live. And I thank CFA for teaching me that. Currently, I am studying to be a certified medical biller and coder, as well as assisting with online radio station WKIR. I just want to thank all the teachers, the staff, First Lady, Bishop, everyone at CFA to help create the Christian I am today and instill in me values that I can take with me and share with others. Thank you.
It's worth the investment. It is totally worth the investment. Students, you may stand. You may stand. I'm going to ask the teacher. teachers to direct them where they need to be. And of course, we have treats for you, okay? You did a great job. Let's give them another hand. Woo! I didn't know all of that was gonna take place. They had a surprise for me. I'm telling you, I am just humble for what God has done with Christian Fellowship Academy and with the wonderful, wonderful children that you have allowed us to invest in. So we are thankful to the Lord for that. I'm sorry. All right, and as they transition and go where they need to go, we are going to, again, let's just give them another hand. Thank God for the teacher that works so diligent with these wonderful children. And I just love every bit of it. And it is a passion of mine. Never in a million years I have thought that I would be doing what I'm doing today. A principal seen this in me when I was 18 years old and spoke it over my life. And I said, you gotta be kidding. But God, he knew that I had to run into Miss Dr. Ruth Counsel in Valdosta, Georgia to speak that into me, and then, of course, to see it come to existence. It is just phenomenal. I have always had a love for children. I don't know why I didn't have 5 or 6, but God gave me 125, so I'm thankful to the Lord for that. Totally thankful to God for that. So with that, of course, Bishop, come on back. We thank God for each and every one of you, and we want to thank you for your participation. And now you see what we do here. And Christian Fellowship Church, you are very much a part of this. And what I mean by that is that you invest in us, and you are our rock. You are the one that we had to pull from, when things were not going as well as it's going now. And thank God for your love, your support, and for how you have invested into the lives and the minds of these children. Because I do believe that we'll be seeing some on television. I believe that some is going to run for president. Some are going to be operating on you one day, or your children one day. All of the above. These are doctors, lawyers, pastors, missionaries, and engineers, and all these different things that we instill into them, because when they know who they are, they can soar anywhere in life. And they are loved by us every day. And of course, we tell the parents that, you know, more likely they are with us more than they are with you. But I want you to know that your children are in good hands, very good hands. So let's give God a praise for that. Now with that, we have our tithes and our offerings that we want to receive. And of course, we want to be a blessing to the kingdom of God. And so we ask that you raise your hand if we want to be a blessing to the kingdom. Here, we give tithes and offering. And, you know, if you have another church that you attend, of course, give your tithes there. But you can give an offering. And an offering goes to help us to do what we do here. And it helps us to keep the kingdom of God moving forward. So if you can and will, before you leave, parents, let's invest into the kingdom of God. And if our church family already know, we give 10% of our earnings every month plus an offering, and then we watch God move on our behalf. Yes, there is vision to move over to the other side. And as we are prepared to do that, and God is opening doors and making ways out of no way, we are thankful and grateful because we know he's ordering our steps. So while you're filling in your envelopes, we're going to ask our media department to come forth with our announcements at this time.
Hello, CFC Power Team, and welcome family, guests, and friends to another edition of Uplifting News. I'm your host, Debbie Kennett. Get ready to celebrate another year of anointed praise, powerful word, and sincere service to the Lord with our very own Pastor Rayfield Boyd and First Lady April Boyd and the members of Christian Fellowship South for their 4th annual church anniversary. This special event will take place Sunday, February the 21st at 3 p.m. at the South location, 1305 South Main Street in Perry, Georgia. Our very own Apostle Bishop B will be the guest speaker. Power Team, let's be on one accord with our brothers and sisters in Christ and make this anniversary a very momentous occasion. Now, speaking of momentous occasions, I have the perfect way to show your support for CFA with Family Fun Night on Monday, February the 22nd from 4 until 9 p.m. Come on out and bring your entire family for an evening of delicious dining and wholesome entertainment at Stevie B's in Kathleen. A portion of your purchase will go to support Christian Fellowship Academy in training champions for Christ. And men, you will be talking like champions on this night as well with Men Talk beginning at 6 p.m. Don't miss this evening of fun, food, and fellowship. Wow, women of worth, are you ready to improve your individual life in Christ? Then don't miss our very first gorgeous gathering of the year, Saturdays, February the 27th, beginning at 10 a.m. right here at CFC. Our very own Dr. Veronica GB, the gorgeous Bee Queen herself, is calling all ladies 13 and up to join her here for a time of real talk from a Christian woman's view with nothing but love and true fellowship. Don't miss it, and please be encouraged to bring a friend.
The CFC Teen Ministry is kicking off their first teen social of the year with a movie night. There will be prizes, games, snacks, and fellowship. It'll take place on February 19th at 6:30 p.m. at the Huntington Park Clubhouse. Teens, come on out and bring a friend. Please see Sister Ashley or Brother Rondell Newsom if you have any questions. The Usher Ministry will be having a meeting in the Fellowship Hall on February 24th, 2016 at 6 p.m. Please see Brother Meshach McConner for further details. Please be in attendance. It's time to give honor where honor is due. Come join us on our Founders Appreciation Celebration. We are celebrating 23 years of service to God's wonderful people. It will begin on Friday, March 4th at 7 p.m. with special guest Pastor Kenneth Kirksey, followed by Pastor Solomon Edwards, March 6th at 8 a.m. and Bishop L. Spencer Smith at our 10:45 a.m. service. Mark your calendars and make plans now to attend each and every service, as well as be a blessing to our man and woman of God. See you there. And now our technology moment of the week. To everyone here at today's service, every time you come to church, check in on our Facebook church page and it will mark your attendance for the month. At the end of the year, the family with the most visits and check-ins will receive a $500 prize at this year's Watch Night service. So, remember to check in. Also, if you haven't already, like our page while you're at it, and invite your family and friends to like us as well.
that concludes our announcements at this time, but please remember to visit our Word and More table located in the foyer for your copy of the message in its entirety on drop card, or you can place an order for the message on CD or DVD. Either way, they all make a great way to improve your giving, as our bishop states, invest and invite. Until next time, keep improving in God. I'm Debbie Kennedy for Uplifting News.
Amen. We thank God for those announcements. Of course, will you please stand? And parents, if you can and will you please stay around, as our bishop will bring forth a word of wisdom for us, and it won't be long. And of course, we'll get you out in a timely manner. And we do have seats up front. For those that are standing on the wall, if you want to come up front and be seated, that's fine as well. All right, let's go before the Lord in prayer. God, we are truly thankful and grateful for what you have done on this day. And God, we know that, Lord Jesus, that it takes money to invest into our children, to invest into our ministry. And we thank you in advance for those who are obedient to you by giving their tithes and giving their offerings, oh God. We ask your blessings upon everything that we give. Lord, you said in your word that if we give, it shall be given unto us. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, shall men give unto our bosom. And God, we just thankful that you are a God that holds true to your word and to your promises. And we are so indebted to you, God. This is the least that we can do, is give to your kingdom. We give you praise, we give you glory, and give you honor. In Jesus' name, let everyone say amen. Amen. To the hands of our ushers, of course, you know which way you all need to turn. All right. Okay. You all turn to the wall on this side right here. And then you all turn this way. This way, yes. There you go. There you go. All right. All right. Now you're in the hands of our ushers at this time.
Joy of the Lord. Excited you know just what to do. I am so excited I know just what to do. Amen. What an awesome God we serve on today. Hallelujah. Blessings, glory, and honor, they all belong to the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessings. And we thank God for all of our children again. They have just done a wonderful job. Let's give them another great big hand. Hallelujah. We are just so thankful to the Lord. And this morning we had an awesome time. This morning in our first worship was such a blessing. Amen. Hallelujah. This morning I was having some technical difficulties this morning, and they gave me another source here, and I'm trying to work it, so praise be on the Lord. I might have to go back old school until they get me shot up. Hallelujah. Amen. What an awesome God we serve. Amen. Amen. If you will, I want you to turn to Matthew, the 25th chapter. We're going to Matthew 25. Hallelujah. Glory be unto God. Matthew 25. Where's Jerry? I unlocked this thing. Matthew the 20th, Matthew 23:1 is our foundation. 23:11 is our foundational scripture. 23:11. Don't mean to boil your patience today. It says, but he that is greatest among you shall be your servant. And I want to talk very briefly today, talking about serving made better. Say that with me, serving made better.
Serving made better.
Serving made better. I need you to go over to Romans, the 12th chapter real quick. Romans 12:7. And there, I'm going to be reading out of the NLT. Romans 12:7. It says, if your gift is that of serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, do a good job of teaching. If you are a preacher, see to it that your sermons are strong and helpful. If God has given you money, be generous in helping others with it. If God has given you administrative ability and put you in charge of the work of others, take the responsibility seriously. Those who offer comfort to the sorrowing should do so with Christian cheer. In verse 9 it says, don't just pretend that you love others. Really love them. Hate what is wrong. Stand on the side of good. Are you still with me? Love each other with brotherly affection and take delight in honoring each other. May the Lord add a blessing to the hearers, most of all the doers of his holy word. He says, if your gift is that of serving others, serve them well. Serve them well. Serving made better. Serving made better. Well, it's really fitting that we are here today and we are in our what we call Black History Month. Very fitting. Very fitting. When I think about serving or improving your serve, when I was we called it junior high back then, but really it's middle school now. I can remember taking a class in tennis. Anybody ever took a class in tennis? And, you know, we got into class and everything, and, you know, we weren't really interested in learning really how to play tennis. We just got excited about hitting the ball over the fence. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I mean, we really was in there to learn, but it was not about how hard you could hit the ball, but it was about how you can control the ball and still have power with it. And so, you know, our instructor would try and teach us how to control the ball or what have you, but, you know, we were more bent on trying to hit the ball hard and everything and have you to know that we wind up in the net, all out of bounds, and everything else. Amen? When I think about serving and improving your serve, there's a young lady that comes to mind by the name of Sharina Williams. Amen. Y'all got me right now. Y'all know I'm still old school. Y'all got to make sure I'm right. Amen. Sharina Williams. And let's see, they interrupted my story now. I was already gone now. And I have you to understand that she is the number one female player in the world. Number one female player in the world. And I'm telling you, she has one of the greatest serves you can ever, ever have in tennis. Amen. And what I found out in serving a tennis ball, one must try and place the ball or the pointer in the court in such a way that there would be no return. And I believe in our day, no one can do it better than Serena Williams. And I mean, she knows how to do it. They say when she serves well, her game clicks. If the serve is good, she's good, her mother says. And what makes it so great is what I've come up with is six keys that makes her serve so great. I'm going to give you those and I'm going to sit down. Y'all didn't even start my time. You need to start it. But if you don't start it, no, I'm still going to go. The first thing that the first key to her greatness or her serving being so destructive, because a lot of folk cannot return her serve, is the mechanics. Everybody say the mechanics. All right? Williams' motion is deadly in its simplicity. She is calm at the line, and her windup is silky smooth, her toss regular, her leg thrust power, her swing compact, and there are no hitches. Sampras says that it is all one smooth, continuous motion. It's natural progression and a big snap at the end, and the motion itself is flawless. In the world that we live in, as Christians, our movement must be smooth in order to serve humanity. We must have a natural progression that draws others to Christ. Are you following me? And the way we've been engineered should help us succeed in serving. Now, if you're taking notes or if you have a phone, if you have a iPad, I want you to go to your Bible app on your phone if you got it, or you can download it, and then if you click on it, you go to live, all of the points will be there. You won't have to even write. They'll just be right there. As Christians, our movement should be smooth, progressive, and consistent in order to draw others to Christ. In other words, our mechanics should be in such a way that it is intact and it draws others to Christ. And I just got to work on my mechanics. Say it with me. I must work on my mechanics. Now, in order for you to be able to be smooth in your delivery and consistent, you got to work on that. In life, you have to work on your mechanics so that one can become what? Better. Secondly, when you see Serena Williams, when she's playing tennis, she's got a great ball toss, and it is disguised in such a way that it's really hard to return. Her hand toss is higher than some, and almost always in the same place, and it's rarely varies. She does it the same way consistently, mostly always. Williams also has a great disguise in the follow-through, making the direction difficult to read. And we should have it on automatic. We automatically serve without thinking about it. That's what Christians do. Our ball toss should be the same every time. The way we serve should be the way all the time, with love, patience, and joy. And people may not understand why we continue to serve like this. We continue to serve with love, with patience, and with joy, and they don't understand why we continue to serve that way.
really, really, in the day that we live in, if you are going to be deemed as a believer, someone who believes in God's word, someone who follow Christ, someone who has been named a Christian, which means to be a disciplined follower, you are going to have some trouble. Jesus said it like this. He said, now, if they hated me, they will hate you. So, listen, I mean, when the Bible says, be aware when all men speak well of you. Because I'm going to tell you something. When you want to do it the right way, there will be some chatter. There will be some talk about you doing it the right way. So when I was hanging out in the world, my buddies, they were hanging around with me, man. We were just really hanging out. And I'm telling you, we had it going on. But as soon as I say, man, my life has changed. I have accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and said, man, dog, why you want to go do that? They wasn't happy for me. They say, oh, yay, he gave Christ a chance. He done accepted Christ in his life. Boy, I'm telling you, that's the best thing you do. Not, what you want to do that for? Immediately, when I said that, the light was turned on. And darkness was ready to scatter. Hallelujah. Get saved. You don't have to worry about, getting rid of your friends, your so-called friends, or changing friends. They're going to leave you. You don't have to worry about it. They're going to leave you. And the ones that really are your friends, they're going to still hang around. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But let me tell you something. Since I've accepted Christ as my Savior, this is the best time of my life. Listen, I get to enjoy everything now. Before, I couldn't enjoy everything. Hallelujah. I didn't enjoy hallelujah. I didn't enjoy anything, well, my God, because you know how it is. You up late at night and you know, hallelujah, you trying to sleep during the daytime. You could enjoy the stars. What's that? Hallelujah. And my eyes are clearer than they ever been before. Somebody get that after a while. Hallelujah. But not only that, she has an awesome ball toss. But thirdly, she has what they say, she has leg power. Now, at 5'9", Williams is shorter than many bigger servers because she more than makes up for it with her explosive legs and her strength, and which is the source of her 120 miles per hour first serve power. 120 miles per hour. Now, she hits the ball on an average at 120. But I have you to know she does not have the fastest speed recorded. Her sister, Venus, has the fastest speed recorded. Amen. I know you didn't know that, some of you all. You thought she had the fastest one, didn't you? But Venus is a lot taller than she is. But it's her leg power that makes up for it. And she uses it to her advantage. And, you know, really, a lot of folk don't use their lower muscles, their lower trunk muscles with such effectiveness like she does. But the thing is that she takes advantage of her lower strength. And as Christians who love serving, we have what we call Holy Ghost power. No, not leg power, but Holy Ghost power. The power of God to help us to continue to serve mankind. We're talking about making service better. As Christians, we possess the whole, we possess power that comes from the Holy Spirit that aids us to continue to serve mankind. Yes. Not only that, but when you look at her game, she has what they call the second serve acceleration. William has one of the best top spin serves in the sports, and her racket head speed means that she can hit her second serve with margin and precision, and she rarely double faults. And what I got out of that is, as believers, we would love to get it right the first time. Amen. But just in case we don't get it right the first time, just in case we don't give God give God what he deserves the first time, God has a way of giving us another chance to get it right. Look down and tell about it. You don't have to double fault. Hallelujah. I mean, you can get it right the next time around. And I don't care what you've been doing and what you've been through today. Today is your day to get it right. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Today is the day that you get it right. And not only that, but then she has what they call is accuracy. Say it with me, accuracy. Now, what is power without accuracy? William has both. She's able to come up with a big serve or paint the lines under pressure and the true signs of a superior serve. Now, power and accuracy is what we aim for. We don't just want to hit the ball. We want to place it within the lines of the court. Mm-hmm. And what good is it to hit the ball with power and you can't stay within the bounds? See, the key to the game is to stay within the boundaries. There are a lot of folk that they want to just go around in life and be out of bounds and still want to win in life. You can't win in life always out of bounds. You've got to be within the boundaries so that you can advance in life. If you go out, wherever you go out of bounds, that's where they start to play over again. If you're playing football, that's where they will start to play over again. You cannot advance. I don't care how far you ran down the field out of bounds, but you cannot advance, my God, from the place that you went out of bounds. You must start where you went out of bounds. I'm talking to somebody here today. Yes, you have gone out of bounds, but today is good news. You can start where you went out of bounds. Are you hearing me? Not only that, but she had what we call self-belief. Serena doesn't doubt herself. And when the rest of her game is off, she knows she can count on her delivery to keep her in the match. And just like Serena has belief in herself, we have confidence that God is going to use us to serve others or help others to succeed. And when we help others, someone comes alongside and help us. Amen. Are you hearing me? Let me tell you something. Everybody understands that without service, nothing gets done. Amen. If we're going to advance in life, we're going to get anything done, somebody has to serve. Our country would have never advanced if somebody didn't serve. The only reason why you have advanced as much as you have, there have been people that have gone before us and have served before we got here. Without someone serving, making the sacrifice, no one advances. Can you say amen? So if no one serves, nothing gets done. Yeah, you need to tweet that. If no one serves, nothing gets done. Some people, they don't want to serve. They don't want to do anything. Let me tell you something. If you don't serve, you will never have anyone to serve you. Are you hearing me? And the thing is that Sharina, she knows how to serve under pressure. Her serve is her dominant weapon. I got to ask y'all something. What is your dominant weapon? Now, here's a few dominant weapons in sports. I'm almost done. You've heard of the fellow by the name of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. You want to know what his dominant weapon was? His dominant weapon was the skyhook. Are y'all hearing me? Simply put, the most devastating offensive weapon in the history of basketball, period. Better yet, an exclamation point. The skyhook was unstoppable. Bill Walton says of a signature shot of the leading scorer in the NBA history, 38,387 points. He could shoot it from the front. He could shoot it from the side, from the free throw line, from halfway down the lane. He was deadly with that skyhook. He had what we call a dominant weapon. Not only that, but Hank Aaron had a dominant weapon called his bat. After 755 home runs, I would say that the bat that he had was his dominant weapon. I believe that everybody in here, God has given you a dominant weapon. You remember a fellow by the name of Usain Bolt. His legs are his dominant weapon. Astonishing is one of the words most often used to describe the world record holder at the 100 and the 200 meters. And as part of Jamaica's 4x100 relay team, legend is another. Bolt is at the 6'5". I mean, he is one of the tallest runners that's in the world today. And it was considered to be really tall. And to be tall and dominate 100 is unheard of. Men that are tall aren't supposed to be able to get out of the starting block fast enough to win the shortest sprint. But the hype does have advantage. Bolt, all he needs is 41 strides to reach the line where most of his competitors need the range of 45. In other words, his strides are longer than the average person. And so all he has to do, has you taken mainly one step, he done already took two. We've heard that before. Somewhere the Bible didn't say it, but we done heard that somewhere before. Hallelujah. Amen. And so his world record number is 9.58 in the 100, 19 in the 200, and then 36.84 in the 4x100. I mean, when he's healthy and motivated, everyone else is basically running for second place. His dominant weapon is his legs. Hallelujah. And I'm here to tell you that God has given all of us an ability to serve where we are. Hallelujah. Has given us ability to serve where we are. And I want to ask you, what is your dominant weapon as I take my seat? Your dominant weapon is the ability that God has given you. Now, everybody in here, we got at least one gift that God has given us. And we've got to be able to use what God has given us. Now, I want you to ask the people down your row, ask them, say, are you using what God has given you? Thank you. You need to use, come on, tell them, say, you need to use what God has given you. He has given all of us an ability to do something. Man, let me tell you something. When I look at the word of God, I'm going to close my Bible. When I look at the word of God, I see the patriarchs of old. Abraham, his dominant weapon, you know what it was? It was tithing. He tithed, and he tithed to Melchizedek. And God, I'm telling you that from that tithing, I mean, everybody in his family began to do Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, right on down the line. And that was his dominant weapon that brought into his household the things that he needed. Moses had a dominant weapon. You want to know what it was? It was a rod. He said, Moses, what is that you got in your hand? It's an old rod. That rod was able to cause the sea to open up. My God, everything that he pointed it to, it turned into a blessing. Not only that, but Joshua had a dominant weapon. It's called leadership. Joshua said, for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I'm telling you, in this month of servanthood, this month where we're talking about improving in our serve and making our service better, you've got to forget about yourself and begin to think about somebody else other than yourself. Can you say amen? Amen. Samson, his dominant weapon was his strength. One time God used him with a jawbone. That was his dominant weapon. God can use things that other people will say, what in the world is that that you're using? How in the world can you use a stick? How in the world can you use a rod? God will give you something to use. David had his leadership. That was his dominant weapon. His music was his dominant weapon. He played the devil, the evil spirit, out of someone. Amen. And Joseph, his dominant weapon was dreams and interpretation of dreams. Hallelujah. Solomon, his dominant weapon was wisdom. Jesus, what's your dominant weapon? My life. He gave his life as a dominant weapon to win the entire world. He gave his life that we may come to know him in eternity. Hallelujah. How and what will God give you to serve humanity? What has he given you? I'm telling you, there's something inside of you that needs to wake up because God got something inside of you. And you are to serve him with what he has given you. Use what he has given. Now, there are fundamental principles God has given to help you prepare to serve. He's given us our mechanics, our ability to do. He's given us confidence. He's given us power. He's given us power that comes from the Holy Spirit. He's given us prayer where we can talk to God. How's your prayer life? Do you talk to God? How in the world did you want God to use you when y'all not on speaking terms? The only time some of you spoke to God when you came here today. All week long, you've been running around, hustle bustle. You haven't even said, good morning, Lord. Thank you for waking me up. You just got to put your clothes on and ran out of the house. But he uses our prayer time. And then he uses our praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We can use our praise. Amen. Amen. And I thank God today that he allows us to give him the praise. Because God inhabit the praises of his people. In closing, how's your serve? Is everything perfect? Can your serve be made better than where you are right now? Some of us came to church today because we was asked to. Some came out of habit. Some came because, well, you know, man, my wife, woman, come to church. Some of us came to fill a square just to say that we've been. Some came to see the children, then they look so cute. The children. But are you improving on your service? See, you didn't have to be here. God ordained for you to be. I'm not just talking about here in this service. I'm talking about on this earth. Do you realize that the enemy, every day, he's plotting and scheming to take you out every day? Man, I'm telling you, when you look at the news and you see young folks, how they're leaving here. There's a young man that came here, I think it was last year, year before last, that was playing right here on this stage. And they just had his funeral on Saturday. He was 30 years old. 30 years old, had heart failure. 30 years old, 30 years young. Right there, sitting right over there. 30 years old. See, my thing is that you need to serve God while you have the opportunity. What's gonna get you closer to God? Listen, you know we believe in education because we got a school here, CFA. But education by itself won't get you closer to God. Listen, what would get you closer to God? We live in a society where we need more money, but money alone not going to get you closer to God. We live in a world where, yeah, you know, we like friends and we like people to like us and we want to feel sociably accepted. But if everybody loves you, that still won't get you closer to God. Are y'all hearing me today? And a lot of us, we want to climb up the ladder of success, you know? And we want to move up in life. And we want to get promoted. And we want to be the top person. But climbing up the ladder of success is not going to be the thing that gets you closer to God. What's going to make our society, and even in the political arena, even if you decide to run for office and you make a whole lot of changes in our society, the political arena is not going to get us closer to God. Well, what is it, Bishop? I'm glad you asked. I'm going to get ready to go in my seat, but I'm glad you asked. You know what's going to get us closer to God? You know what's going to get us closer to God? A changed heart. A changed heart. We need God to change our hearts. Let me tell you something. If man's heart gets changed in any community, I don't care. You can go, what's the worst community? Well, let's go to Macon. Hallelujah. All right, we got some people here make for Macon, though. But let's go somewhere far beyond. Let's go to Chicago. They can't talk today. We'll pick on them. No, but anyway, wherever you find, listen, when you change man's heart, you don't have to put up the bars around the windows and the doors. You don't have to have as much security systems and all that kind of stuff. When man's heart is changed. The Bible said that man's heart will wax worse and worse. Now check this out. I remember coming up when you can leave your doors open at home. Anybody don't know? You didn't have to lock your car's doors. That's back then. Anybody remember that? And then sometimes you can leave out the house and you left your door wide open. And come back and find everything in place. Leave it open now. No, you don't have to leave it open. Lock the door and forget to put the alarm on. You know what I saw? Man's heart has hardened more. It's going to take a changed heart. We're going to get better, and we're going to see better. We got to serve God and helping others change their heart. Put your hands together. Give God praise. Everybody stand up. Everybody stand up. Connect with the person next to you. Create in me a clean heart, Lord. Renew the right spirit within me. Change our heart. Make it ever new. May our heart be just like you. Why are you holding that person's hand today? This really is a time for you to search your own heart. Are you maximizing your life in serving others? It really has to become an unselfish thing. It cannot be just about you. It has to be about someone else. And you cannot accurately serve God if you don't have a relationship with Him. Because when He speaks to you, you won't know it because you don't have that type of relationship. He's got to know you, and you've got to know Him. It's mutual. There's a whole lot of folks in this world that say, I know God, I know God. But it just can't be one-sided. God must know you. And that's what I'm afraid of. Many of us going to just, you know, leave this earth saying, I know God, I know God, I know God. But when you meet God in judgment, He's going to say, who are you? Depart from me. I never knew you. So the key is that God knows you. We can say all day long that I know God, but that don't make us know Him. But today we have an opportunity to give Him not just part of us, but all of us. Some of us just need a fresh new start, just to basically start all over again. And some of us need to just say, you know what? I never really gave God a chance or a try like I really should. But today, I'm going to do it. Today, I'm going to do it. But give Him. Would you bow with me? You're at a point now of deliberation. There's a time of decision in your life where you can really say, God, I really need to make a change in my life. And I believe that you can change me. I believe you can do that. It's really not a hard thing to do. It's not about what someone else thinks about you. It's not about how people will respond to you. But it's about what God is doing inside of you right now. And if you're standing there, you know that, hey, you know, Bishop, I mean, the little few words that you gave me today got me to thinking about where I am in my relationship with God. Whether or not I am improving in my serve. I can't improve my serve because I'm too busy worrying about things that I really shouldn't worry about. And those types of things are what's occupying most of my time. The things that I don't want to worry about, I don't want to think about, but those are the things that occupy my time. Well, God wants to free you of that, brother. He wants to free you of that, sister. Where you trust Him with everything about you. Seen and unseen, you trust God for your life. That's where He wants you. At a place where you say, you know what? I can't see it. I can't put my hand on it. But by faith, I know God's got me. He's got me. So if you're here today, and you feel that, you know what, Bishop? I really believe I need Christ in my life. I want you to hold that thought. Secondly, you say, you know what? Listen, I really need to rededicate my life. Because I know what God has done for me. I just ignored and turned away from what I'm ready to turn back to. And then thirdly, you say, you know what, Bishop, I really need a church home. This looked like a nice place. I need, me and my family, we need a place of covering, a place where we can call a home away from home. I want you to hold that thought. Then fourthly, you say, well, Bishop, you know, I really haven't been serving like I should. And today, I needed that. I needed to be reminded that God has placed something in me. He has put an ability in me to help in this society, to serve others, to help somebody become their best. And I haven't been in that place. And then finally, you say, well, Bishop, I'm at this place now where I just really don't know. I'm in a place where I just don't know. I've walked this life for some time, but I just don't. I'm in a place of not knowing. But I want to know. I want to know more about the direction in which God is taking me. I want to know what He wants me to do fully. That's what I want. Well, whatever situation that you stand here today, and you know that God is dealing with you on, this is how I want you to participate. But this, because this is about you and God. It's you and God, your relationship. Whether you obey Him and what have you, because the Bible says you draw nigh to Him, He'll draw nigh to you. But if you reject Him, He will reject you. So today is about you and God, your relationship. That's what it's about. It's not about anybody, it's about you and God. You and God. So whatever reason that you know that you just need prayer today, on the count of three, I want you to just squeeze the person's hand next to you. One, two, three. Come on, just squeeze that hand. Just squeeze it. They'll know that, hey, I stand with you, brother. That's why I asked you to join hands anyway, so you won't feel that you're by yourself. Somebody else is connected to you. Somebody is there for you. We let you know that, hey, we here with you. So squeeze that hand. Listen to the Holy Spirit. Listen to your heart. Listen to your mind. It's telling you now that, listen, you know what? You really need to get prayer over this. Because I feel God directing you and leading you. So go ahead and do that now. Just squeeze that person in. That's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. You made the decision to squeeze that hand. You made that decision. Now do me a favor. If that person next to you squeezed your hand, just lift it up like I got mine lifted up all over the room. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Put it down. Put it down. That wasn't hard, was it? That was not hard for you to just squeeze that hand and say, you know what? I thought about my life and I need prayer for this, that, or the other. That is so simple. The devil tried to make it hard. He tried to block you, try to camouflage your blessing. He wants you to bury your blessing. We talked about that in the early service, burying your blessing, but we're not going to do it today. Today is the day that I allow God to help me in my request. And whatever that request is, I'm telling you, God is going to help you in it. Now do me one last favor. If that person squeezed your hand, would you bring them down to the altar? Just bring them on down real quick. Come on, y'all, help us celebrate their coming. Come on, help us celebrate their coming. Come on. If you squeeze your hand, bring them on down. Come on down. Come on down. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. This is the real test right here. Bring that person down. If you know that they squeeze your hand, bring them down. This is the real test right here. This is the real test. That's right. Come on, cheer them on. Let them know you're with them. Come on, CFC. Y'all know what they do. It's still coming. Come on. Cheer them on. They see them coming. Come on. Let me tell you something. This is what an old preacher told me. Said prayer won't help you. It sure won't harm you. That's what we're getting ready to do. We're getting ready to pray for you all. And wherever God is taking you, I know it's going to be something great. I already know it. It's going to be something spectacular concerning you and your family. The enemy is the only one to try to make things difficult, try to make things hard. But God got you right where he wants you, in a place where you can think about your own life. And you make the choice whether or not you want to give God everything that you have. Now, if you brought that person down here, that's fine. You can stay with them, because we're going to pray with them and pray for them. Or you can exercise your right to go back to your seat. But I have people already been deputized. They're going to pray with you. They're going to hear your requests out. We're going to all pray together. I'm going to ask my prayer, my altar workers to come. Come on. My altar workers to come. Come on, altar workers. Come on. Come on, altar workers. Come on, altar workers. Come on, altar workers. Raise your hand until they get to you. Raise your hand until they get to you. Raise your hand until they get to you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on. Come on. Raise your hand until they get to you. Hallelujah. Come on, altar workers. Y'all moving too slow. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, Ella. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, you still have the opportunity to come. You still have the opportunity to come. You still have the opportunity to come. If you want to come down here, I'll sign somebody to you. If you want to come to the altar, this is your time. We're going to pray with you. We're going to pray with you, sir. We're going to pray with you, man. This is your opportunity. This is your opportunity. This is your opportunity. Those of you that are in the audience, point your hand in this direction while they work with them. We're going to just do it softly so they can hear them while they're talking to them. Hallelujah. That's right. Just point your hand in this direction. Let's begin to pray for them. Come on. You don't have to know their name. Just begin to pray. Let's intercede for those that are at the altar. Come on. Some of you, you should come down because God is dealing with your household. He's dealing with you as the leader of your household, brother. He's dealing with you, my sister, about the support of your household. And if you would just come down and just allow someone to touch and agree with you and pray with you. I know you want things to get better. I know you do. If you just come down, somebody's going to touch and agree with you. My brother, he'll just come. I need somebody to come and pray with him. Come on. My sister, he'll just come. Somebody pray with her. Hallelujah. He's coming. Who else? Who else wants to come? Don't be ashamed. Don't be bashful. Come on. Come on, this is what altar call is all about. This is the help that you need spiritually. See now, if you needed help educational wise, we will direct you into a university. I need somebody to come pray with my sisters right here. Sister Boyd, would you pray with them, sisters, sweethearts right there? Hallelujah. Is there somebody else? Somebody else want to come? I'm so glad you changed. Somebody else. Okay, this husband and wife is coming. I need somebody to pray with them right quick. Right here, I need couples. Would you come and pray with my sister, brother, right here? Who I got there for all this? Okay, first lady, you going to pray with them? All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, never mind. Somebody else already coming. Thank you for coming, sister, right here. First lady right here, the sister with her baby right there. This way. Oh, never mind, somebody got it. Who else is coming? Who else is coming? Who else is coming? Who else is coming? Father, in the name of Jesus, we stretch forth our hand as they make a decision today. This is a blessed time for them to come to know you. Oh, God. We want to be at a place where we can serve you. We want service to be made better today. This is a new beginning of our lives. This is the first day for the rest of our lives. And so today, we make an effort, a bold step of faith, a leap of faith. And say, God, here we are. We don't want to double fold in our lives. We thank you for giving us another chance to do it right. But God, let us accelerate our lives from here. Give us the power to do what we need to do. We thank you right now, oh God, for giving us the mechanics, for giving us, God, what we need to do what you've called us to do. For today is the day of salvation. For today is a brand new day concerning the lives of those that are on this altar. And we pray that they will receive you, they will receive your word, and that they accept their change in their lives. For today, when they leave out these doors, they'll leave change. Change in their heart, change in their mind, change in their spirit. A new person, a new brother, a new sister. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you for this brand new day. It's in Jesus' name. Let all of God's people say amen. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. There's some that are still on the altar. Is there anybody here that needs Christ in their life? Anybody here that needs a church home today? We want to give you the opportunity to be a part of this family. Anybody here? Anybody here? Anybody here? You don't have to be afraid. This is your time. We take this opportunity to share with you. This is your time. Get it right with God. We don't know when God gonna call us. We don't know what tomorrow holds, but we know that he has tomorrow. But we do have right now. We can participate in right now. Hallelujah. And I thank God for our right now. Don't you thank God for your right now? Woo. Awesome. Awesome God. Awesome God. We bless God for you today. Hallelujah. Amen. You put your hands together. Let's give it our prayer. You may be seated. You may be seated. If you can, you may be seated. What an awesome God. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It is a great day. It has been beautiful. It has been wonderful. Amen. I pray that the words that were spoken, that it would help you serve better, serve humanity better, serve your brothers and sisters better, better than you ever have before. Because it's not about us. It's all about him. Amen. Put your hands together again. God bless you. Love you with the love of God. This brother here gave his life to Christ today. Let's give God praise. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God praise for my brother. Isn't that wonderful? Happy for this brother right here. Ha-ha. Bible say, be rejoice over one. Elder Jones, brother, I want to give you some information and things that you need as you have gave your life to Christ. We don't want to, you know, have your new baby in Christ. We don't want to just leave you hanging out there, but we're going to give you some information and we're going to help you develop your faith and help you start your way, your new beginning. We're excited about your future. Aren't we excited about his future? Hallelujah. So Elder Jones, raise your hand, Elder Jones. All right, Elder Jones right there, he's going to take you. Is that your wife right there? Just friend? A fiance? Okay, you can go with him if you want. But Elder Jones right there got his hand lifted right there. He's going to give you some information so we can start you on your way. Let's give God praise for him. Hallelujah. Isn't that good? Hallelujah. You may be seated. We've already given our tithes. We've already given our tithes, but we want to give an offering today. We want to give an offering to the Lord. If this service blessed you in any way, some of you came from other churches to be here with us. As the First Lady said, you should always give your tithe to your local church where you get fed. If you don't have a church, you're in between churches. Hey, this is as good as another. Hallelujah.
But you can give an offering at any time. You can give an offering at any time. At any time. And so we ask that you would lift your hand so that you could be a blessing in this offering. Man, we're excited about that brother that gave his life to Christ. Amen. We rejoice with him. See, this service was designed just for him. Amen. And not only for him, but a lot of us who are going to renew our efforts in serving humanity. Amen. This has been a wonderful service. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give God praise for that. And on top of that, I want to say happy Valentine's Day to everybody. Today is the 14th. So happy Valentine's. And I hope everyone had a great Valentine. Amen. Amen. Is today y'all anniversary? All right. Today is Pastor Lady Boy anniversary. 18 years. All right. 18 years. Isn't that wonderful? Today is the day. 18 years ago, they said yes. I will do. And they still doing, and they still will. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you is our prayer. All right. Anyone else need to be served today? Anyone else need to be served? Would you stay with us until we do the benediction? We're going to receive the offering, then we're going to do the benediction. You want a copy of the DVD from the service from the babies or whatever like that? You have to go to the table and put your order in. Amen. If you want a copy from 8 o'clock service of the CD, you can put your order in for that as well. Hopefully we'll see you on Monday. It's Men Talk. Monday is, no, not this Monday, because Monday is holiday. This Monday is a holiday, so no Men Talk on holiday. We don't really try not to take you from your family on a holiday. So tomorrow is a holiday. But I see those that are ministry training on Tuesday. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. And then Wednesday night Bible study, second to none. You got to be here. We have real Bible study over here. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. And Friday night, we had an awesome time at the Sweetheart Ball. I laughed so much, my jaw got tight. Hallelujah. We had an awesome time. Awesome time. Are we ready now? Let us stand. These are one of the few times that I just talk to you. Hallelujah. Let us look to the Lord. Father, we thank you for these offerings. Some came in after we have given our tithe and they want to give now. But we thank you, Lord, that it's a seed that we sow, not so much that we give grudgingly or giving with dirgery, God, but we thank you right now because this is a time where we share with you and give back to you because we love you. And this is above and beyond any tithe. This is our offering, what we want to share, what we desire to share. We thank you for it. Now bless, as your people will give, bless some 30, 60, 100 fold back. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. These two sections face each other. These two sections face each other. That section face the wall and come around. Stay with us until we do the benediction. I'm going to do it right after we come around with our offering. So good to see you today. All right. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. God bless you. Yes, it will, hey, God, and around, and around, and around, and around, hey, late in the midnight hour, God's gonna turn around, it's gonna work, yes, it will, hey. Ready to go. Everybody standing on their feet. Because if we don't, we'll sing that too long and then we'll be here too long. God bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you again for coming. Let's give God praise for those that have come to be with us today. Hallelujah. Amen. Find you three people and tell them that you have the victory and the devil is under your feet. Find your three. Tell them, say, you got the victory and the devil is under your feet. We get ready to go now. Let's raise it up. Put your hands together. Put your hands together. Put your hands together. Hey! 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 What you say now? What you say now? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Gonna hit it right here. I gotta ask y'all a question. Who's got the victory? 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 Here we go. Who's got the victory? Come on. Guests and visitors, a great big hand, all first time. Oh, yeah. Now look at somebody with your green face on, the leadership, you can take your way. They must look funny to you. Tell them this.
I got it, I got it, I got it. I got it, I got it, I got the victory. Yeah, yeah.
Say it again, say it again, say it again.
I got it. Ooh, yeah.
it does not stop here, but we'll go out and we will bless someone else by showing them that we have the love of God. We thank you for all of our guests. If they're here visiting their loved ones, we pray that you give them traveling mercies back home safely. If they're new in the area and they're looking for a church home, we pray that they will look favorably upon this one. We thank you in advance for all that you're going to do with you in us, through us, and around us throughout the rest of this week, God. We pray that we will serve one another, we will serve our communities, we will serve wherever we go, and we will make that place better. We thank you for it now. Be with us until we come back together again. In Jesus' name, let all of God's people say amen. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you on the next time.